Hello, welcome to Afromax Solutions. In our previous discussion, we talked about limits of sequence, where we just look at an example. And in this tutorial, I want to look at yet another example, example two. We are proving that, limit of n squared plus 3n divided by 2n squared plus n minus 1 as n approaches infinity is equal to half. Alright, so this is what we are proving. Okay, so yeah, we learned in our previous lesson that given anything of this form, then there is an equivalent statement. So to prove this, we need to come out with an equivalent statement, which is that given any epsilon positive, so given any epsilon positive, there exists certain n, big n, which is a function of epsilon, and it belongs to the set of natural numbers, positive. There exists big N, which is a function of epsilon, and it belongs to the set of natural numbers, such that for all small n greater than big N, we say that the absolute of this particular sequence, which is n squared, as 3n, divided by 2n squared plus n minus 1 minus its limit should be less than epsilon. So that's what we are moving towards. So this should be less than epsilon. That is what we are proving. So let's see how we prove that this is actually less than epsilon. So here we have the absolute of n squared plus 3n, and divided by 2n squared plus n minus 1 minus half. Right. So this particular one is going to be equal to. So we just look for the LCM and see how best we can do that. So looking at this, the LCM is going to be 2. So let's write it here. We have 2 into brackets 2n squared plus n minus 1. Alright, so we have this still in the absolute symbol. And we realize that this here, this can cancel all this, and 2 goes to multiply all these things. We have 2n squared and plus, so 2 is still there, we have 6n and minus. Alright, so the 2 here comes to cancel this. We are left with 2n, so it's minus, so we have 2n squared plus n minus 1. Yeah. Alright, so whatever we have is actually equal to, so we have 2n squared plus 6n, in our case it's 2n squared plus 6n, so minus, so we have minus 2n squared. And then so we have minus n, n plus 1. So minus 2n squared minus n, 2 plus 1. And divided by, so we multiply this, we have 4n squared. 4n squared plus 2n minus 2. So that's what we have. Now realize that this and this will cancel, and giving us this minus that gives us 5n plus 1. Alright, so and then divided by 4n squared plus 2n minus 2, you know, so it's now. Yeah, at this point, we want to introduce our inequality sign, because without that, we won't be able to show that all this is less than epsilon. So we want to introduce the inequality sign. And at this point, introducing less than means that what you write after this
should be greater.
Alright, so first of all, we have this to be the same as 5n plus 1. We have 4n squared plus 2n minus 2, because for natural numbers, any value that we substitute for n will get positive results as we have it. Good. Now, we want to increase the numerator and reduce the numerator and reduce what's the denominator. Okay, so in increasing the numerator, we will not do away with the 1, because when we ignore the 1, it means we have reduced the numerator by 1. So we can increase the numerator to any value. So I, with my own discretion, I want to increase the numerator to 6n. So it has an increase to 6n. Then I reduce the denominator, so I do away with all this. So I'm left with 4n squared. So you attest to the fact that whatever we have here is greater than what is here, because we have increased the numerator and reduced the denominator. So the fraction we have here is greater than what we have initially. So n can cancel one of the n's here, and this, you say that this is the same as saying 6 divided by, so the 6 and the 4, they have a factor in common. So you can see that here will give us 3. We have 2n. So we have something like that. Now we need to introduce our epsilon. So here again, we want to see how best we can introduce the epsilon. So we hide somewhere and pretend that we know how to introduce the epsilon. But before we do that, realize that this space is small n. And in the definition, we were told that small n should be greater than big N. So there is a need to introduce the big N, then we look for the epsilon. So introducing the big N will mean that this will be less than 3 divided by 2N. Now to introduce the epsilon, we just equate everything here to epsilon. So we hide somewhere and say, okay, 3 divided by 2N should be equal to epsilon. So quickly make big N a subject. So you realize that you're going to have something like 2 over 3 epsilon to be equal to N. So we just come back and, as if you know already, say that choosing N to be equal to 2 over 3 epsilon means that in place of big N, we're going to substitute 2 divided by 3 epsilon. And when we do that, we realize that whatever is here is going to be less than epsilon. Right. So once we've been able to show that all this is less than epsilon, we can conclude. So you conclude that therefore the limit of the sequence limit here is the limit of n squared plus 3n, alright, so divided by 2n squared plus n minus 1. So this one, yes, something we're trying to do here. As n approaches infinity, it's actually equal to half. So the proof is there. Alright, so that is that. Keep working hard, it's not difficult, you can still do it. Alright, so for more tutorials on this, you can like our YouTube link, subscribe, and if you have more challenging questions, we are there for you. Don't forget to call on us, we'll be helping you in everything that you need. Thank you very much.